Let's discuss the electric field strength due to a uniformly charged circular arc, which we can see here. This is a circular arc subtending an angle phi at its center, and it is of radius r. Now, in this situation, we are required to find the electric field strength due to this arc at its center. So, we can directly state this electric field will exist in the direction of its angle bisector. We draw the angle bisector, it will be in this direction. And in this situation, if we wish to find out the electric field, we just consider an element at an angle theta from the central line of angular width d theta. This is an angular width d theta which I have taken here. You can carefully analyze it. And so this is the element which is having an angular width d theta. Or linear width, it will be given by r d theta, r is the radius. And on this element, the charge dq can be easily given as total charge on angle phi is uniformly distributed. So, for the small elemental angle d theta, it will be q by phi into d theta. This is the charge on this element, which can be taken as a point charge due to which electric field at center will exist in the direction directed away from the element of magnitude d at the same angle theta from the central line. So, we can write electric field due to elemental charge dq is, this d can be written as by using the electric field due to a point charge, that is k dq by r square. And again, if we integrate it from one end of the arc to the other end, its direction will change. So, we resolve it into two components, that is d cos theta and perpendicular to the central line, which is d sin theta. Here again, we can see by symmetry, when the element is integrated from one end to the other end, all components of d sin theta on left hand side and right hand side will cancel each other and d cos theta will be added up. So, we can write net electric field at the center of arc is given as E at center will be integration of d cos theta. We just substitute the values. This will be integration of k dq. We can write q upon phi d theta by r square into cos theta. And limits of integration will be applied for the angle theta that will be integrated from one end to the other, that will be minus phi by 2 to plus phi by 2. So, your electric field at center we can write as this kq by r square, phi r square is a constant. We integrate cos theta d theta from minus phi by 2 to plus phi by 2. So, here the result will be kq by phi r square, integration of cos theta will be sin theta within limits from minus phi by 2 to plus phi by 2. So, the final result we are getting is this will be sin phi by 2 plus sin phi by 2. It will be 2kq sin phi by 2 upon phi r square. This will be the result of electric field due to a charged uniformly charged circular arc at its center if it is subtending an angle phi at the center of the arc.